Italian cuisine is Italy's gift to the world. From top to toe, the map of Italy is a patchwork of gastronomic treasures that come not from a tradition of great chefs, but from beloved family recipes. Italy is the home of slow food, and Italian cuisine is largely about regional cooking. From one region to the next, produce, recipes, and traditions vary.
Salute.
Labels like DOP, DOCG, and IGP guarantee that certain products are harvested from a specific area and made by local farmers and artisans. But labels aside, the essence of Italian cuisine is in its simplicity, in how a few modest ingredients can come together to create something magical. And this is what keeps us coming back for more. Do come and join me. Let's get to know the people behind the produce. Let's step inside Italian kitchens. Let's eat the best of Italy from top to toe. I'm Margarita Forres, and this is My Italy. When you're tired of the hustle and bustle of Naples, hop on a ferry and head to Isola d'Ischia. At the west end of the Gulf of Naples, Ischia is the lesser-known neighbor of Capri. Not quite as glamorous, but in my opinion, much more charming. I'm heading back to Ischia after 12 years, and I can't wait to see the Green Island again. If you're familiar with the movie The Talented Mr. Ripley, this is where the character Dickie Greenleaf lived. More recently, Elena Ferrante's My Brilliant Friend from the Neapolitan series was also filmed here. So what is Ischia to me? Years ago, I came to this enchanting island for the sole purpose of learning how to make pizza. The person who taught me has since become a dear friend, and I'm overjoyed to be seeing him again. It's so good to be reunited with Gaetano, and the years just fade away. Gaetano is a master pizzaiolo, and his pizzeria has been serving local families and visitors for decades.
Gli auguri oggi la festa della mamma.
Oh, he's gonna make me cry.
La voglio ringraziare per il suo affetto, la sua nostra amicizia e il bene che voglio a te e a tutta la tua nazione.
Oh, grazie Gaetano. Dalle Filippine anche tanti amori per
adesso
per te.
Prepariamo un po' di pasta per le pizze.
Ok.
We catch up for a bit, hug a little. And then, just like old times, we seal the bond with pizza.
So it's like 12 years never passed. We're doing this again. We're gonna start making dough like the first time.
In goes the water, and then the salt.
E poi, sì?
Adesso è.
Non ho dimenticato. I didn't forget. You're supposed to dissolve the salt in the water.
And then the flour, one scoop at a time.
Prima facciamo camminare.
The machine begins mixing the dough, and all the memories start coming back.
So I was here last time for 5 days with some of my other chefs, and we learned how to make pizza, and we must have made like 3,500 pieces of dough. And it's all just coming back to me.
To the dough mixture, live yeast is added.
C'è un po' di pasta qua.
Okay. Andiamo ad orto.
Gaetano's like my bear. Can you imagine? Gaetano is the fourth generation already in his family of Pizzaiolo. So his father, his grandfather, his great-grandfather, his nonno, was also a Pizzaiolo. So siamo just nati. Imagine.
So siamo nati nelle pizze.
They were born in the pizza, no?
Siamo oggi, facciamo quasi, diciamo minimo 9 anni, circa 50 anni di pizzeria.
Can you imagine 50 years of making pizza in their family? I mean, that's a real legacy.
Together, we make the pizza balls, or the all-important impasto, the foundation of any good Neapolitan pizza.
So you have to pull the dough, pull it twice, and cut it like you're strangling someone.
Margarita, guarda, uno, Margarita, uno, due.
Due.
Ecco qua.
Okay.
Margarita, questo è mio cognato, vedi? Anche lui pizzaiolo.
No, mi ricordo lui. No, non siamo conosciuti prima.
It's my old friend Louis, still here after all these years.
It's a bit challenging to make the dough.
Okay.
So this is where I learned the term no stress. This is what Gaetano taught me. You have to like just be gentle and roll the dough. Bello?
Bellissimo.
Okay, grazie.
Bene.
But I think it's like riding a bicycle. You learn it once, and when you do it again, it comes back to you. Uno.
Gira, gira, gira.
Tre volte.
Tira, così.
Okay.
The impasto will then be left to rise overnight.
Stretching the dough.
While the impasto that's ready can now be stretched. Dough preparation is the hardest part. After that, everything else is a matter of speed and technique. The next steps have to be done quickly but carefully. A ladle of tomato sauce, cheese using two hands, some basil leaves, a sprinkle of parmigiano. And really, it's all about the right proportions.
And now, a little oil.
Okay.
Uno. Facciamo insieme, eh?
Vedi zucca.
Non incidenti.
Okay,
vai.
Okay.
In it goes.
Okay.
Piano. Piano. Vai.
Qua?
Sì, vai.
Così?
Tira, tira. No, proprio.
Okay.
Sì. La tua pizza,
è bello, dai.
Niente qua. Ecco la Margherita. Bella Margherita, beautiful Margherita.
Stai scherzando.
No, verità. Ok, andiamo,
I said he was joking, he's teasing me. He said, no, it's true.
Ecco
it's not bad, ah.
Pizza Margherita. A handful of good ingredients, exceptional technique,
chin chin.
Salute.
And
salute.
Look at this. Buono.
Mm. Oh.
Bella. Buona.
Dani Maison is a 2 Michelin starred restaurant in the middle of nowhere. And that's exactly how Chef Nino Di Costanzo likes it.
Wow, chef.
Actually, this is Nino's grandfather's house, and he wanted to honor him and his memory by coming home to Ischia and opening a restaurant.
Tutto della zona.
Not just any restaurant, but one that would celebrate the produce of the region of Campania. Nino has cooked all over the world with the best of the best. But home is where the heart is. Today, in Nino's kitchen, I saw how he is not only a chef, but an artist and a dreamer. Look at all the work that goes into preparing spaghetti with tomato 5 ways. With 5 varieties of tomato, some from his garden and all from the region. Pomodori, or tomatoes, is a pillar of Italian cuisine, and there are hundreds of varieties across Italy.
So here we have our ramato tomato that was processed in the pasta salsa, and then our oven-baked ciliegini, the water from the datterini, and then of course the ox heart, the cuore di bue, that we just extricated the cuore di bue interior. And then of course, we still have the datterini that are baking, and chef is working on peeling the ciliegini. So from our ciliegini that were oven baked for 2 hours with the thyme and the rosemary, the garlic and the oil, chef made a cocce. First we had the just the ramato tomato puree, and then we added the blanched cherry tomato, ciliegini, and then we added the concasse, which is the semi-dry already. And then
now the
datterini water, and then now the datterini that was oven baked.
And now cuore di bue.
And finally the cuore di bue center. It's complete. Now it's complete. It looks very simple, but imagine all the care and all the tediousness that went into the preparation of this wonderful dish. Sale pepe, solo sale, just salt. So chef just seasoned it with salt and a little olive oil. And the basilico, and that's it, finito.
I'm so thrilled to get to plate this dish with Chef Nino. From the choice of serving plates to the finishing touches, Chef Nino expresses the artist in him.
Now we're gonna taste it.
Look at my big bite. But please imagine with me what it tastes like.
Semplice, ma.
La cosa più importante è proprio la semplicità.
Sì. La cosa. Ho capito. Chef says that the most important thing is the simplicity, and you can see it in the dish. Si può saporire Ischia.
I told him you can taste Ischia and you can also taste the heart of the chef. Elegant and deceivingly simple, but there's science, research, and lots of imagination that went into this dish. And it is not something I will easily forget. As if I weren't impressed enough, Chef Jacopo starts on another signature dish of Dani Maison. Risotto con latte di bufala, bruschetta e ricci. A peek into some of the ingredients shows parmigiano aged 24 months, shallot confit, lemon juice and lemon zest, sea urchin, ramato tomatoes, and frozen basil pearls.
So all the ingredients of a bruschetta in a risotto, I'm just like, chef just took my breath away.
I have never tasted anything so incredible. Chef
Nino is a Japanophile. He has been visiting Japan since he was 19 years old. He says from the Japanese, he's learned much about discipline, precision, and aesthetics, all of which he brings to his own food. Dani Maison is an intimate 16-seater restaurant. There are only four tables that seat four both inside and al fresco, and the customer chooses whether to eat inside or out. In good weather, I'm almost sure outdoor dining is preferred. Chef Nino has the most beautiful garden, filled with flowers, herbs, lemon trees, and lots of seemingly random art pieces. But nothing is random, because everything Chef Nino Di Costanzo does is precise and just the way it should be.
Chef, it's so beautiful!
Pantalone, an Ischia native and a friend of a friend, is my guide for today. He tells me that the Castelo Aragonese di Ischia is not to be missed.
But Marco, how do we get up there? Do we have to like walk through like winding steps or stairs?
No. Fortunately, you just get there, yeah? And you can take an elevator which takes you to the top of the castle.
Elevate, okay, magic word, elevator, okay. So, shall we go?
Yeah, let's try.
Let's go.
After finding out how many times he's been to the Philippines and how fluent he is in my language, we hit it off right away. Castelo Aragonese di Ischia dates back to the 5th century BC. A bridge connects the castle to the island. Before the bridge, about 3,000 families lived in this fortress. At one point, it had 16 churches, including a cathedral. Today, it is owned by one family. In 1912, it was auctioned off to the Matera family, and over the years, they have carefully restored the castle to its former glory while opening up spaces for art exhibits and events.
My God, this view is just so breathtaking.
All around the island, you will find beaches, sand beaches or rock beaches as well.
That's what makes Ischia a little bit different, no?
Yeah. You know what? In 2002, the Pope came here.
The Pope? Wait, this is Pope John Paul, no? Wow.
John Paul II.
Oh my gosh. That would have been amazing.
2002 came here.
Yeah?
When you can see the square right there. And they build up a stage.
Wow.
A lot of people on that side, people from the windows, from the balconies of the buildings.
I can imagine.
And also, all the bay here. It was full of boats, and there were plenty of persons on the boats.
Just to see him. Well, that's like the closest you can get to heaven, I guess. The Pope and beautiful Ischia. I mean, what else can you ask for, no?
I asked Marco to take me to his favorite seafood restaurant, and he says he knows just the place. Seafood restaurants line the shore, and the local favorite is Coco Mare. Marco is friends with the family that owns Coco Mare, so we pop into the kitchen and see the catch of the day. We leave Antonio in peace and pick the best table in the house. The one with a view of the magnificent Castelo Aragonese.
To Ischia and grazie.
We are about to enjoy the bounty of the sea, harvested from the waters below us just this morning.
How is it?
Wow.
Yes, it is.
this is priceless.
Yes.
Eat beside the Castello and then have this gallinella, no?
Yes, this is gallinella.
This is gallinella.
Yeah. Coccio gallinella.
And it's so, so incredible that you also enjoy fish head here.
Yes.
I'm so excited because in the Philippines, I eat a lot of that. Mm.
In the kitchen earlier, I was surprised to see that fish head is actually a prized ingredient. In fact, nothing is thrown away. Again, it's cucina povera. The fish is called gallinella, and everything is used. Head, the jaw, the fins, all go into making a very flavorful stock.
The fish is just so sweet and...
Yeah, and also the pasta is really, really...
And I learned a new shape, mezze paccheri.
Mezze paccheri, yes.
Delicious.
Mezze paccheri is a pasta variety that originated in Campania. It is shaped like a very large tube, and it's perfect with a gallinella.
And you know, this restaurant is really special because during summer, people just come here just to swim. And after they swim, they're really, really hungry.
Yeah.
And as you can see and you can imagine, they come here and they have this seafood or grilled fish or like something like this, tuna, yeah. Crudo.
Everything refreshing.
Everything, yes, exactly. And the interesting thing is that you really have it right here. You can see it here.
Yeah. I can imagine how many kilos of pasta chef probably has to make at the height
every
of the
day,
season.
Yeah.
In Italian, it's canocchie. In Campania, it's called ciccarelle. In English, it's a mantis, and it tastes like the sea. So fresh and so bright.
Salve.
Yeah.
Grazie. What a treat. Oh, fish is here. Wow, this is the big eye.
Huh? Yeah, yeah. Just salt.
Another head.
Oh, look at the skin. How does it
crispy.
Come out? Yeah.
How do they do that?
The chefs at Coco Mare are masters of the grill. The big eye is simply coated in a layer of salt and then expertly grilled so that all the moisture is contained. The fish is filleted table side, and just by looking at it, I can see how tender and moist the flesh is. I can smell it too.
Two of us are speechless. We're like watching him like a doctor.
It is served with a sauce of lemon, olive oil, and a bit of rosemary.
Grazie a Dio. No, really, truly, this is like heavenly, absolutely heavenly.
Ah, Ischia. It took me 12 long years to come back to you. But now I've found you again, and I'll never let you go.